one of my favorites. This is the tale of Io, an Onibaba who gave birth to an inhuman army, imbuing them with an unnatural strength and a wicked hate that rivaled her own. The ghosts set out to stop Io before her army became invincible. Soldiers were empowered by Io's rage, her vengeful spirit. As long as she remained, they could not fall. Ghosts hit their mark, but Io lived on, for they had only killed a servant.
The ghosts! Bring them to me!
Inside me. feeding. Please, you must stop the Onibaba. She's entered the sacred forest.
Through ritual sacrifice and bloodshed, harnessing pain and anguish, the disciples of Io were able to power her army. As long as the disciples remained, her
Tsushima is part of me now. Ever since that day, sacrifices. Humans always have to sacrifice. Tsushima is part of me now. Ever since that day, sacrifices. Humans always have to sacrifice.
Go! Go!
Ghosts knew their only hope of stopping Io was to save the other monks before she could consume their spirit.
I was a woman once, long ago, but that was before that day, that horrible day.
As the ghost drew near to a mysterious village, they discovered a terrible sight. Honorable spirits held prisoner, used as stores from which Io fed. As the ghost drew near to a mysterious village, they discovered a terrible sight. Honorable spirits held prisoner, used as stores from which Io fed.
Take this! Does one drop in a pond make a difference?
As the ghost drew near to a mysterious village, they discovered a terrible sight. Honorable spirits held prisoner, used as stores from which Io fed.
Nothing but a husk.
Yeah.
Although the ghosts freed the body, the spirit was no longer there. The disciples dispersed, the prisoners freed. This army defeated. Io grew eerily silent. But had she been defeated? Or had she simply moved on to somewhere else? Listen while I recount an adventure of the ghosts.